Hello guys, welcome to the knowledge domain, the concept of life sciences and biotechnology. In today's lecture, we are going to discuss a typical eukaryotic cell, the structure, and further we'll explore briefly the functional aspect of each organelle. So a cell is a structural and functional unit of living organisms. The first animal cell evidence goes back to the Vanadian period, which is almost 650 to 544 million years ago. It starts, the living organism can be a single or it can be a multi-billion cell plant or the animal organism. Our human body composed almost 100 trillion cells. The size, we call it, ranges from 1 to 100 micrometer. But there are examples like the 0.1 micrometer for the pleuro pneumonia-like organism. Ostrich egg diameter is almost 180 millimeter. Scleroderma fiber is almost 60 centimeter. And the knot that passes through the spinal cord, those are almost 100 centimeter in length. The various shapes like the polyhedral, spindle, long and branch, flat and spherical, columnar or cylindrical, and biconical. The credit or the cell terminology was coined by the Robert Hooke in 1665. He designed a new compound microscope in which he visualized the slice of the cork. And from the Latin word, cella means small room, he called these structures as the cell. And these findings are published in Micrographia. In 1676, Anthony von Leeuwenhoek wrote to the Royal Society of London that he has the evidence that the cells, whatever he is visualizing, they are living in nature. In 1833, Robert Brown, first time, he proposed the presence of the nucleus and he saw the nucleus inside the cell. Then come to the time of the cell theory. 1838, Sladen proposed it and followed by the Swan in 1839. So the parameters of the cell theory or the explanation is that all living things are composed of the cells or their products. In 1855, Rodolphe Virchow added that cells are formed through seasons of the pre-existing cells and all the cells of a living organism is made up of the living cells. Viruses are exceptions to the cell theory. Then coming to the ultrastructure of the cell. So this is the animal cell, this is a plant cell. Here you can see the cell is protected or it is all the internal component of the cells are preserved inside by structure that is called the plasma membrane that is selectively permeable and it controls movement of the substances across it. So it is also involved in the functions like cell signaling and the cell attaches itself to the extracellular matrix or to the other cells. This is called the cell adhesion. Then coming to this one, this is the mitochondria. So this is the place where there is the synthesis of the ATP takes place by the aerobic respiration. And this is the place of the cellular respiration. So it uses the substrates of the oxidation of the glucose and the fatty acids by the glycolysis and the citric acid cycle. And through a series of oxidation process, there is a synthesis of ATP. Thus, it is called the powerhouse of the cells or the energy factory of the cells. And it is a double membrane structure. There is an outer membrane, there is an inner membrane, and the inner membrane is folded into structures like the cristae and the space inside the cristae or it's called the matrix. And the space between the two membranes is called the intermembrane space. And this mitochondria has its own ribosomes and has its own DNA. Then this structure is the lysosome, which has an acidic lumen. And this is called, in this acidic lumen, there are the enzymes, hydrolytic enzymes, which are there to digest substances by hydrolytic cleavage, and thus is called the suicidal bag of the cells, and it is responsible for the garbage disposal and recycling of the organelles. Then there is the nuclear membrane or the nuclear envelope. This is also a double layer structure, and it encloses the substance present inside the nucleus, and there are pores in it. And the outer membrane of this nuclear envelope is, you can see here, it is continuous with the raw endoplasmic reticulum. Then you can see there is a dark stained structure here. This is called the nucleolus. It is the place for the ribosomal RNA synthesis. And this entire structure that is enclosed by the nuclear envelope, and there is a nucleolus, and all these substances, this is called the nucleus. So nucleic acid is suspended in the cytoplasm without a nuclear membrane. It is called the nucleoid. So inside the nucleus, we know that it contains the genetic material, that is the DNA. And in case of there are some organisms, we know they have the genetic material as the RNA, but in the eukaryote, this is the DNA. As well as there are the proteins which help in the folding of this DNA or the chromosomes. This is the place where there is a transcription takes place, so that the messenger RNA along with the tRNA as well as the, all the regulatory RNA are getting transcribed. Then there is the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. You can see here, the smooth endoplasmic reticulum, it looks like there is no ribosomes here, so it is smooth. And this is the place where there is the synthesis of lipids, as well as the detoxification of the certain hydrophobic molecules take place. And we can see the continuous raw endoplasmic reticulum here, because this is raw, because there is the presence of the ribosomes here, which are responsible for the protein synthesis. As well as, and the place inside this ribosome is called the cisternal space or the lumen. So you can see the space inside this ribosome. These are called the cisternal space or the lumen. And this endoplasmic reticulum, there is the processing and the sorting of the secreted proteins into the, there are the transport vesicles here. So from the endoplasmic reticulum, the secreted or the processed samples through the transport vesicle, they reaches to the Golgi complex. So this Golgi complex, they processes and sorts secreted proteins. So they are responsible for the trafficking of the substances. And you see the shape of the Golgi complex. It is a semicircular, or it is a crescent lunar-like structure, where you see the convex part is towards the nucleus or towards the endoplasmic reticulum, as well as the concave part is towards the cell membrane. So this is called the receiving end, which is convex in nature, and this is called the secretory end, which is concave in nature. Receiving phase, and this is the releasing phase. So this is the receiving phase, this is the means releasing phase. Then these are the secretory vesicles. So whatever is there in the Golgi complex, they are through the secretory vesicle, they are secreted into the extracellular environment. Then there is the peroxisomes. So there are the enzymes that break down the fatty acids into the smaller molecules used for the biosynthesis and also detoxify it. So these are enclosed within it so that the cell is also protected. So these are the peroxisomes. So here the plasma membrane, the lysosome, the nuclear envelope, the rough endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi complex, and the secretory vesicles, these are called the endomembrane system. As they modify, they package and they transport lipids and the proteins. Then there is the cytoskeletal fibers. Here, these cytoskeletal fibers are the microfilament, and there are the intermediate filaments, as well as that there are the microtubules. So the microfilaments, they are found in the cellular cortex, and they are responsible for the cellular components, as well as they are responsible for the cell division. And in case of the tissue like the muscle, they are responsible for the contraction, and they also form the microvilli like structures. Then there are the intermediate filament. Intermediate filament, they maintain the integrity of the cells and they hold the organelle together. Then there is the microtubules. These are the largest among them, and these are hollow at the center and they maintain the cell shape. And this cytoskeletal movement, they also help in the movement of the cells. Then you can see the microvilli. It increases the surface area, that we can see the smaller intestine in the epithelial cell. So because of that, they increase the absorption area. Then you can see the vacuoles, which is, there are some protozoans where the vacuoles are found, which are contractile in nature. Vacuoles, that is only found in the plant cells. And these are the cell wall that give the, that is made up of the cellulose in case of the plant. And this is found in the fungus and the protista also. And in case of archaea, this is non-peptidoglycan. In case of the fungi, this is made up of the chitin, the cell wall. So this vacuole, they store water, ion, nutrients, degrade the macromolecules and function in the cell elongation during the growth, and they are responsible for maintaining the torpor. Torpor means it, there is a wilt. When there is no water in the plant, we have seen that there is a wilt, so it maintains the torpor against the cell wall. The torpor phases. Then the 16, there is a chloroplast here. So this is a type of the plastids where there is a photosynthesis takes place. And in the chloroplast, this is also like mitochondria, it is a double membrane structures. There is an internal membrane bounded side, they are called the thylakoids. And each stack is called the granum. And the space between the granum and the inner mitochondrial space, this is called the stroma. The fluid filled in between that, this is called the stroma. And here you can see that cytoplasm of one plant cell is connected to the another plant cell through the plasmodesmata. So this is also a type of the junction. This is the plasmodesmata. Then there are the endosomes. Those are the responsible for the endocytosis. And the centriole, when it is singular, it is the centriole, they form the centriole. They are the self-replicating, and they have the role in the cell division. And these are the place where the microtubule organizing takes place. So these are the microtubule organizing center. Then there is the cilia or the flagella. So you can see the flagella in case of the euglena. And the cilia is found in the paramecium, as well as the cilia is found in the fallopian tube and the retrovertebra. So when it is flagella in euglena, the cilia and the paramecium, they are movement of the responsible for the movement of the whole organism. Whereas in case of the fallopian tube and the retrovertebra, it helps in the movement of something. So in the centriole, as well as in the flagella, the arrangement of the microtubules is, you can see there is the 9 triplets microtubules. They are arranged in a circle, and at the center there are two microtubules. And as we discuss in the nucleus, the outer layer of the nucleus, as well as the rough endoplasmic reticulum, ribosomes are found. Ribosomes are also found floating in the cytoplasm, and these are 18S in nature in the eukaryotes, and in the prokaryotes, like in the prokaryotes as well as in the chloroplast and the mitochondria, the ribosome is of the 70S type, and these are responsible for the protein synthesis. Then the nucleus and the cytoplasm, this nucleus and the cytoplasm without the plasma membrane, this is called the protoplasm. And in the plants, you can find some other type of plastids, which are chromoplasts and the leucoplasts. They store pigments, and depending on the color of the pigment, their color is determined. And there are the structure like the granule that is found in the neutrophil, like the means the blood cells. And when the cell wall is of the bacteria as well as these plant cells are removed, the entire structure is called the protoplast. So here we know that there are two organelles, like the mitochondria and the chloroplast. They have their own DNA. So these are supposed to be the means prokaryotes, and they have the symbiosis relationship with the eukaryotes. Like there are the vitamin K producing microbes in our human gut, and we coexist. So similarly, the cyano, the photosynthetic bacteria, become the chloroplast in case of the plant. And in case of the prokaryotes, when there is no nuclear envelope, that type of floating of the nuclear material in the cytoplasm is called the nucleate. So next is the movement of the substances across the cell membrane. So we know that plasma membrane is selectively permeable. So what is the type of the movement? So one is the simple diffusion, that is the movement of the solutes from the higher to the lower concentration. Osmosis is the movement of the solvents from the lower to the higher concentration across a selectively permeable membrane. Filtration is the force by which you let the substances to move to a membrane, that is called the filtration, like we use pumps. Then in the active transport, the substances, they move against the concentration gradient, so there's the need of the energy. And endocytosis is the, by the vesicle, transfer of the particles of the droplets from the extracellular environment to the intracellular environment. Whereas the exocytosis is the transfer of the substances by secretory vacuoles from the intracellular environment to the extracellular environment. Then cell division is the process by which the cells are formed. This is responsible for growth, repair, replacement in the body. And in this process, the nuclear material as well as the cytoplasm division takes place. In case of the somatic cell, the cell division is called the mitosis. In this case, it results in the two identical cells, which are identical to their parent cells also. And the stages of the cell divisions are the, in case of the mitosis, prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and the telophase. The eggs and the sperms are the gametes. They are produced by a special type of nuclear division called the meiosis. In this case, the chromosome of the parent cell, it halves in the gametes. And this is nuclear division is called the karyokinesis. And after the karyokinesis, the division of the cytoplasm is called the cytokinesis. And the time or the all the stops that is taking place between the cell division is called the interphase phase. It is a period between the successive cell division, and it is almost 84% of the time that is taken by dividing cells. Then tissue is a group of cells that have similar structure and that function together as a unit. The non-living material present between the cells is called the intercellular matrix or the extracellular matrix. And they have the components like salts and fibers. These are unique to specific tissues. and it depends on the distinct characters of that tissues. Some examples in the triple helix of the protein known as collagen in case of the animals, and in case of the plants, if there is an example with the pectin. So bone, cells, spicules, hardened structures are formed of the extracellular matrix when it becomes calcified. There are four types of the animal cells, like the epithelial cells, connective tissues, muscles, and the nervous tissues, whereas the plant, these are the vascular, epidermal, ground, and the meristem. Thank you.